Here we go. Okay, ready? Go. Okay,
Mike.
Okay, one, okay.
Ask, okay, go.
Okay, let's do it. Take one. Take
here we
two.
Go. I'll look, try it again. Okay.
Take here we
two.
Go.
Cut that again.
Ask a question.
That's a good question. Well, first of all, we're 2 years older.
I got a pain right here.
I think we're a little more mature. And as musicians, that's very hard to come by because we're known for being children that never grow up. I think that's one of the neat things about Petra. We have five guys who know where they're going.
Can I run over to Walmart real quick?
Know where they've come from.
Started back in my childhood.
I mean, that's important.
A fly, oh. Must be that hairspray. It couldn't be me.
Last 2 years, we've done everything from do a Spanish praise and worship album for South America and Spain. We have played at Farm Aid, which was an experience in itself. We've accomplished a European tour that we really felt was very, very successful.
The longing the Europeans have for good Christian music and the way they'll support it if they're given the opportunity It just blew my mind.
We plan to make Europe a regular stop.
Boy, to be able to talk about Jesus Christ and to have a bond with somebody you've never met that's the other side of the earth is just a remarkable feeling.
As far as a highlight, there's been many. I mean, we did something at Farm Aid, and that was, to me, that was a highlight because it broke another barrier. We walked out and did three songs that praised the Lord, and they were like stunned but respectful, and I think a lot of them respected what we had to do. It was televised all over the country. They got to see a Christian group be Christian.
Thank you.
Oh, there's a big difference. All the other albums have been done in Los Alamitos in California. This was done in Nashville.
Working in Nashville has afforded us the possibility, in my case, to drop by the studio every couple of days just to listen, offer suggestions, learn a little bit.
I've never recorded like that before. This first album I've ever recorded where I lived in the same city as I recorded. And it was a real joy for me. I really liked it a lot.
Working in Nashville has been a great pleasure, especially when my wife was in her ninth month of pregnancy. What is this? Every time we have a record, we have a child. I think we need to stop that trend.
And you guys look like you've been at the beach.
That's because we've been
That's on because you're artists. I'll make...
Can we get serious here?
Love is gentle, makes no demands. love stands the test. Love is God.
Something that would be really coming from a different kind of angle. And Brown, of course, is an excellent producer and has a great track record.
There's a very open door policy with working with Brown Bannister. He's very in tune with listening to what your suggestions are.
I mean, guys, relax.
These guys have been the hallmark in, you know, Christian rock. This group has been, you know, a big part of creating the genre. And so it's an honor from that standpoint, because what they've done in the past has not been bad. I mean, they've done some really great records. We've got all sorts of eclectic arrays of guitars. Bob's brought in every amp known to man.
There can only be one Bob Hartman of Petra, and that's me.
Dependent upon my senses, that dancing.
I need to hear from you. Wake Up Call actually wasn't a name of any song, but it seemed like the collective whole of all these songs started bringing a central message that interplayed to each other.
Definitely a unique band effort, most definitely, with all five people having a very direct and very open and honest input on song selection on every single thing.
Four of the five guys wrote at least part of songs. Which I think is also very exciting. Bob and Ronnie wrote three together. Johnny wrote a song with a little help from one of our crew guys. I wrote a song with a friend of mine.
The first one that Bob and I worked on was Sleeping Giant. I think it's very appropriate for where Christians in a global sense are today. Now certainly there's the awakening and a revival in many lives of many Christians, but you know, the body of Christ a lot of times is just sleeping.
in Jesus Christ, His only Son. I believe in the virgin birth. I believe in the man of sorrows, bruised for iniquities. I believe in the Lamb who was crucified and hung between two thieves. I believe in the resurrection on the third and glorious day. And I believe in the empty tomb and the stone that the angel rolled away.
I think we're seeing Christian ideas and ideals fading into the background more and more.
Sometimes you can get lulled and you need a wake-up call so you can hear God.
It's not alarmist, if you will, but I think it is an alarm to say to people, let's wake up and understand this world that we live in today and understand how the world is influencing the church as well as how the church is influencing the world.
Of you, recreated, renewed. Let me reign forever in the likeness, in the likeness of you. Maybe. of me. Jesus, I'm trusting in you. So your likeness, in the likeness of you.
Trying to convey God's love, His saving grace.
We do talk about our faith, sing about our faith in our music.
The kids want to hear music because they want to be entertained, and that's cool. But we want them not only to be entertained, we want a message that's very positive for their lives to sink in.
It humbles you because you know they're looking to you for the answer, and you're representing Jesus Christ, and they're holding on to that because that's all they got left to hold on to. And that's when you realize the magnitude and intensity of what you're doing out there.
They need to know how to study the Bible and how to stand up for Jesus Christ, or, you know, in their generation, they'll fall away.
I think that about wraps it up.